On this page, we will talk about the biological factors that contribute to skin color. There are three pigments that contribute to skin color: melanin, carotene, and hemoglobin. Melanin is by far the most important of the three pigments. Now, what we see pictured here is a very simple illustration of a melanocyte producing melanin and then depositing it in the upper layers of the epidermis. Melanocytes are the melanin-producing cells. They reside in the stratum basale, and they appear to have these cytoplasmic extensions, sort of like an octopus-looking cell. And the branches of that cell sort of weave through the stratum spinosum. And melanin is released from the melanocyte and then taken into the keratinocyte. Once it's in the keratinocyte, it migrates towards the cell's nucleus and sort of shields that cell's nucleus from the penetrating rays of UV light. Now, UV light is present in our environment, and UV light can damage the DNA of cells. And so melanin protects the cells from DNA damage. DNA damage is what ultimately leads to cancer in many cell types, but because these cells are particularly exposed to UV light, melanin protects the skin cells from UV light, preventing cancer. Now, it doesn't prevent cancer 100%, but it certainly reduces the likelihood of skin cancer. Now, all individuals have melanocytes. It's the activity level of each individual's melanocyte that then dictates how much melanin that individual has. So melanin is a pigment that ranges in color from brown to black. It's genetically predetermined. And so someone with very dark melanin would present with very dark skin, and their cells, their skin cells, would be more protected than an individual with a lighter color melanin. When you get to the discussion assignment for this module, you will explore further the function of melanin, because it actually extends beyond just simply protecting skin from skin cancer. It also protects the skin from another important degradation process, and that process would be the degradation of folic acid. And so different amounts of melanin across the globe have evolved to protect individuals from the breakdown of this very important nutrient called folic acid, while simultaneously promoting vitamin D synthesis. So keep that in mind when you're reading the article that is required for that discussion assignment. The other two pigments are carotene and hemoglobin. Carotene, not keratin, but carotene, like carrot, is an orangey-yellow pigment that we obtain through eating fruits and vegetables that have those colors. And that color, yellow to orange, would reside in the stratum corneum, giving individuals a somewhat yellow to orange appearance. And then the other pigment is hemoglobin. Hemoglobin is found in your red blood cells, and when oxygen is bound to hemoglobin, hemoglobin has a red appearance. And so all individuals have hemoglobin, and all individuals have red hemoglobin when oxygen is bound to it. And so individuals that are more fair in their complexion might display a more red skin color because there is less melanin to sort of obscure the hemoglobin, the red from the hemoglobin. But all individuals have hemoglobin. Darker skin, you might just not see that hemoglobin, but it's also there. And so all skin colors are a function of these different shades of browns and blacks and yellows to oranges plus red. And it provides this huge spectrum of skin colors that we see in our world.